Yes, student. Now today we will see the topic that is a B plus tree. Before starting the B plus tree, just let me give you some idea about the tree data structure. In the tree data structure, what we have, what are the various things we have? So just let me clarify to all the things with the help of the simple concept. So I'm just adding one more blank slide for your betterment. Then you can understand the concept in simple. When talking about the tree data structure, so as you know, the tree data structure means a kind of a data structure. The representation of tree data structure will be in form of the tree manner. So it is better idea to let me give you some idea with the help of the simple concept. If I'm just drawing the tree diagram, then you will see understand what are the its various parts. So suppose this is a tree. I'm just drawing a blank tree over here. Just this is the okay tree. And here you can see this is a some parts. So from this tree, the bottom side we can say this is a root. This is a root. And in this base of the tree, we have in this base of the tree we have the many branches. We can have the many branches on top tree. Okay. So this is the point we have to keep in mind. These are the known as the branches, or we can say this is also represented as a subtree because it is a part of the main tree. So we can say this is a branches. Okay. So this is also known as the subtree. Of course, we can say. So with respect to that one, we have to identify what is the height of this tree. What is the height of the tree? That is H I can marking over here. And what is its level of the depth? So we can say what is its depth. From this point, we have to determine the thing properly. So we have the height and depth. Why am I telling the more detail about the tree data structure? So those who don't have any idea, so they can aware about the this thing properly. So that's why I'm taking this concept properly over here. This is just only the general tree by which I'm explaining my idea. But in the computer system, what we have to, in the tree data structure, we have a node. This is the initial node that is known as the root node. That is known as the root node. We can say this is root node. A root node can have the many nodes. So initially, suppose it has a two nodes. So this is known as the left node, and this is known as the right node. A left node or right node can also have the many nodes undoubtedly. So, but I'm taking here two only. Why I'm taking two only? Because I'm representing the my tree as a binary tree. So in a binary tree, a node can have the 0 subnode or 2 subnode. These subnodes means I'm talking about the tree. So this is a root and this is a left node and this is a right node. This can also have the two nodes. This can also have the more than two nodes. But as a binary tree, it can't have the more than two nodes. It can have only zero node or two node. Suppose I'm just increasing this one. It has the two nodes. Okay. So from this perspective, what you are observing over here, you are observing the some concept here in simple way. This is root node. And this node contains the left subtree. So this is the left subtree. I'm marking with the green color, you can easily say. And this is the right subtree. So this is a point I can mark over here. A root can have the two kind of the part, that is the left subtree or right subtree. In the left subtree, we can also have the eight subtrees. So of course, it is also possible. So we can have, just like the in this left subtree, we can say this left subtree can also become have the left sub to subtree. So this node becomes this node. I'm just marking by the this color that becomes a root node at that point. So that is a point we have to keep in mind properly. So this is what this is known as the tree data structure. Why I'm telling more detail about the tree data structure? Because you people are aware about the all these things properly. So that's why I'm focusing on the concept. Now, if talking about the its height, so you can easily say. The height of the tree we can easily determine by the simple thing. So if I need to check its height, so from this last node, all these last node I am marking in a circle. This is known as the leaf node. This is known as the leaf node. Okay, this is known as the leaf node. Please keep in mind properly, this is known as the leaf node. Okay, so all these are known as the leaf node, that is marked by me in the circle. All these are known as the leaf node. While all these are known as the intermediate node, if we have a is known as the intermediate node. Intermediate node. So fundamental concept should be clear to all right now. I am not teaching to the data structure, but I am just giving the idea about the data structure. Because without knowing this thing, you are not able to understand the B plus tree. That is the reason. So this is an intermediate node. Okay, so I can write over here. This is an intermediate node. And root node we have, and this is known as the leaf node. So from this perspective, we have to start the other way. So many things. So let me explain just idea about the height. So what is the height? From just see here, from this point to this point, I'm moving. And from this point to this point, I'm moving. And from this point to this point, I'm moving. So 1, 2, 3. So here, to reach at the root node, the height will be 3 from the its leaf node, that part from the left side. From the right side, I can say this is the one part and this is the second part I'm doing. So here the height of this node will be the 2 from the right side. But what is the maximum value of the height from the left and right side? So you can see this is the 3. So we will see the final value of the height of this tree will be the height of this tree will be the 3. Okay, so the height of this tree will be the 3. So we will pick this value. That is our answer. So from this perspective, we will start the B plus tree. Okay, now is it clear to all about the just idea about the tree data structure? Is it clear to all right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, when we're talking about the binary tree, so please clear this concept right now. We're talking about the binary tree. A tree can have either 0 node or 2 node. That is a simple thing we have to keep in mind for understanding purpose. When talking about the balanced binary tree, so what is the balanced binary tree? So balanced binary tree is saying towards the height of the things in terms of the balanced manner, it should be equal. So from the right and left side, the tree must be equal. So that is known as the balanced binary tree. So that is the point we have to start. But from this example, from this concept, we have to start our topic, that is the B plus tree. So I'm speaking some terms from my slide, so you can understand properly. A B plus tree is primarily utilized for implementing the dynamic indexing on the multiple levels. So far we have implemented the two-level indexing, one-level indexing. But when we need to implement the multi-level indexing, then at a time the B plus tree will help. So compared to the B tree, that is the binary tree, the B plus tree stores the data pointer only at the leaf node. The term we are seeing over the leaf node. Else you will ask us what is the leaf node. So I've already explained this concept, what is it mean by the leaf node, and which makes search more process, more accurate and faster. So actually the data pointer, the record, the information to be stored at the leaf node only. So we will see in this concept with the help of the example. First one, let me explain over here. The B plus tree is a balanced binary search tree. So now the term we have the balanced binary search tree. If you don't have any idea about the binary tree, then how you can understand the balanced binary search tree? A balanced binary search tree means a tree in which we have to search an element. So that is known as the binary search tree. But if tree is balanced of the binary search tree, so we can say it is known as the balanced binary search tree. And it follows the multi-level indexing format. That is, the first we have to search at the primary level, then second level, third level. Unlike this tree. So if I need to search an element, so first I will move here. If it is less than small, then so I can move over here. Okay. Suppose greater than, then I can move over here. Less than, then I can move over here. So depending on the situation, I can move over here. Again, I need to check the condition. It is less than or greater than, so I can move over here. So again, I'm moving over here, depending on the situation. So what I'm doing actually, I'm just pulling the various levels, and that is known as the multi-level indexing. That's why B plus tree is the best example for the multi-level indexing in the database management system. So in B plus tree, leaf node denotes actual data points. So as I told you, it contains the information, and B plus tree ensures that all leaf nodes remain at the same height. That is the point. Again, we have a new term, that is height. So it means the height of the all the leaf node must be same. It means the leaf node from the left side or right side should be equal. In B plus tree, the leaf node are linked list using a linked list. So if we need to implement the practically, if we need to implement the binary search tree or any kind of tree data structure in the computer system, then you must be known to that part. You have to define the linked list to explain or to implement the tree data structure. Why? Because a tree can have the two information. One is its left of tree node value or right of tree node value and its corresponding addresses as well. So it can follow the multi, because it is represented by the doubly linked list. Those who have any idea about data structure, then they know. So doubly linked list is the best example for implementing the B plus any kind of tree data structure. That's why we have this stuff over here. So therefore, a B plus tree can support random access as well as the sequential access. Now see, if element is belong to the right side, then we will have to move on the right side only. If element belongs to the left side, then we have to move on to the left side, depend on the our condition, is it matching with or not. So that is the point you people are required to follow the concept properly. So this is just idea about the B plus tree. I'm repeating once again, B plus tree means a B plus tree is basically a concept and it is required to implement the multi-level indexing in the database minimum system. And in this case, we have to follow the balanced binary search tree. And the point we have once again over the leaf node contains the actual data pointers. It means it contains the actual data values along with the some well, along with the memory address. So let us understand this thing with the help of the rules. Because there are some rules. Without knowing the rules, you are not able to implement the B plus tree. Let me explain. What are the rules? So here we have some essential rules for the B plus tree. So leaves are used to store the data records. It means I'm talking about the data value. Second point is same to us, data stored in the internal node. Now again, we have a question, what is internal node? All the intermediate nodes will be known as the internal node. That is a term you people require to keep in mind while learning the B plus tree. So all the intermediate nodes are known as the internal node. And next one, if I need to search something, so as a role of the B plus tree to search an element, is it available inside the tree or not? So if target key value, that means search value, search element we need to search, is less than the internal node, then point just to its the left side is followed, as I shown over here. If it is less than, then we have to move to the left side. If it is greater than, then we have to move to the right side. Okay. So whatever I have written over here, I am showing with the help of my diagram. So if a target value is greater than or equal to the internal node, then just point just to the right side is followed. And root has a minimum of the two children. Why? Because it is a binary tree. Binary tree can have a zero node or two node. If we are not having any node, suppose we don't have any node, the root node default by default becomes as a binary tree node. And there will be the single node. If you try to search any elements, by default, whatever element as a single element we have, and we try to search a single element, and now it is a part of that tree. So we can easily find out on the single instance. That is the point. But if we have a multiple, so it can have the minimum of the two children. That is the point. From this point, we should have a question. Why we have to use a B plus tree? This is a simple thing I'm spelling over here right now without reading unnecessary point. The keys are primarily utilized to add search by directing of the proper leaf. So what is the leaf node we have on that parameter? We will try to search an element. At a time, the element which are required to search by us is known as a key element. So that is the point we have to keep in mind. Now, second point is saying to us, B plus tree uses a fill factor. Yes, of course, this is an interesting term we have, fill factor. Fill factor means if we need to search an element, if we found it there, if by the rules, if we are increasing or decreasing the size of the tree, then we can manage by the fill factor concept. So this term you have to keep in mind for coming set. So you have to keep in mind this fill factor term. B plus tree, numerous keys are easily placed. So there are the not a single key element we have to use. We can have the multiple data elements that are required to search. So we can follow the use amount of the key elements of these data from which we have to search an element. So it is also possible. And all these keys are represented by the memory. So in the memory, we have to store the all the information in form of the key element or search element as well. But the point we have to keep in mind, the key element we have to search, the key element we have to search, there is no guarantee that this data associated to the internal or intermediate nodes. If it is not available, so it is not referencing, so we can easily access or we can directly access the leaf node. Let me explain this point right now by this example, like this one. In this PPT, I'm just explaining here my words before explaining the any other operation. If 50 is here, so from 50 to 75, I have to search, so I will not go to the 5 to 20 or 25 to the 40 range based leaf node. I will touch only the this range based information, that is the 50 to 75. So that is the point we are saying to us over here. This was the point. Is saying to us, if you looking for the use memory and if you want to retrieve the data directly, then you can access by the help of the random access method. But there's no guarantee the other leaf node will be associated to that part only. So that is the reason we have the little system. Now, next one, a comprehensive full scan of the all the elements in the tree. Yes, of course. If you try to scan all the nodes from first node to the last node, you can scan, but at a time you are using the sequential approach, and this sequential approach is recognized by the linear paths, because all leaves you are looking for the in the B plus tree can be scanned by you from the first node to the last node. So that is known as the linear path you are following, and it is also possible. And unlike the random access, we are able to follow the sequential access manner, so we can also follow. By the time it will be the time consuming process. So that's why instead of the linear path, we will always refer to or follow random access approach. That's why it is also written over here, a random access. It can support random access as well as the sequential access. So if as a good person, if I need to look at my data, so I can directly or I can randomly access without any doubt. So that is the reason. So why we have to use the B plus tree, because we can save the memory by directly jumping on the particular leaf node set rather than the particular or without being touch the other set, we can easily touch now on the specific set to get the data. That is the reason. Fill factor, you will be able to understand when we have to understand the concept of insertion and deletion. So you can understand the fill factor term will be there while increasing or decreasing the size of our tree, while adding or updating or while deleting something. We will see all these concepts properly. So why do we have to use the tree? That is the reason. Actually, that is the reason. Now, this is the point we have a structure of the B plus tree. So before telling to all about the before structure of the B plus tree, so you have any doubt, so you can ask me, right? Just tell me any doubt if you have. So please, you can. Any questions so far?
No, sir.
No, sir. No questions.
Okay, thank you. If talking about the structure of the B plus tree, so I have just designed my PPT for simple purpose. So I have already written the many terms over here. So structure of B plus tree, we have to keep in mind properly. Here you have to understand the B plus tree in concise way. From this structure of the B plus tree, I am remembering some words I am sharing to all people right now. The topic B plus tree is common to the data structure, database management system, and operating system. When we have to study these three important subjects in the computer science engineering subjects as well, then we have to understand this topic in these subjects. Because in terms of the data structure representation, we have a data structure B plus tree inside the data structure as well. But while talking about the storing purpose, we need to understand the B plus tree, then we will focus on the storage mechanism, or we will focus on the data pointer and how it is managed. And talking about the operating system, so in context of the operating system manner, we have a B plus tree. but structure or the representation of the concept will be the same as it is. But the point we have here, B plus tree is more important than the other kind of the deep, other kind of the tree data structure, and it is more important because it is applicable to anywhere. But how you are managing, how you are handling, that is more important. So after understanding this point, now I am focusing on the structure of the B plus tree. The structure of the B plus tree is very simple. You can understand in the B plus tree, each and every leaf node is at equal distance from the root node, and the B plus tree of the order n, where n is a fixed for every B plus tree. So whatever the size we are putting over here, that will be equal to at each and every level. So you can see daisy at coming on the top side. So it contains the some internal nodes reference value. So these are known as the internal nodes. DEG are actually the data value, or this is known as the data pointers, as I told you. See? Data records. Okay, leaf node are used the data record, but this is also intermediate node. So it intermediate node also contains some information. So that is also recognized by the some values. So this is also known as the A, B, C, D, G are what these are the data values. So here D and G are the intermediate nodes. And A, B, C, A, B, D, E, F, G, H. What are these? All these are recognized by the leaf nodes. So internal node also, internal node means we're talking about the, it just keep the reference of the its leaf node. So we can expand as per the desired information. And you can see observe over here from the left side, I have drawn the internal node by the filling the dash dash by the red color. So you can see over here, and the AB are, these are known as the leaf node, and DEF are the leaf node as well. So I make a circle over here, and that is followed by the connection between or communication between the one leaf node to the another leaf node by the arrow symbol, and that can be implemented by the programming way, or practically that can be implemented by the link list. And this is the pointer is known as the block pointer. The term we have to keep in mind, this pointer is known as the block pointer, and this can be implemented by the link list. So there will be relation between the each and every leaf. And now you can say again, I have just written over the link list. Okay, so this is also known as the block pointer. So G, H, E, D, G are the, these are the labels, so these are the value of that one. But how we can expand, how we can understand this thing. So this could be the structure of the B plus tree in simple way. So I have explained over here. Internal node, I am speaking once again, intermediate node, this is not a root node. If this is root node, then it will be only the single part. It can expand. But here we are just taking the structure of the B plus tree in terms of the internal node and leaf node as well. Now, let us explore more about the internal node. So in the B plus tree, what is the various properties of the B plus tree that define the important term? So here we have the two terms in two statements in each and every kind of the node. Internal node. An internal node of the B plus tree can contain at least, my dear student, just focus on the my words which are underlined over here. At least n by 2 record pointer. So internal node can have n by 2 record pointer except to the root node. So root node will always keep only the one record pointer only. While in the case of the utmost, it can have the utmost n pointer. Suppose we have a 4 record pointer, so internal node can have minimum can have the 2, while utmost it can have the 4. So leaf node, we can say leaf node of the B plus tree can contain n by 2. Same. The leaf node also having the at least n by 2 record pointer and n by 2 key values. So key values will be also determined by the leaf node, that is the n by 2 as well. As per the record pointer, we have n by 2. So at most, unlike or like internal node, it can also have the n record pointer and n key values. So leaf node will contain the n values and key values and record pointer, while internal node will just represent the record pointer. Why record pointer? It just keeps the reference of the other leaf nodes as well. So that's why we have the term record pointer in the internal node. Last point in the leaf node is saying to us, every leaf node of the B plus tree contain one block pointer P to the next to the leaf node. And this is just like our previous example, as I told you, this is known as a block pointer P. This block pointer P contain the communication or contain the some data that make the reference of the next leaf node. So we are having the this thing. So that is known as the block pointer. This is recognized by the letter P. So by which we can represent such information. So structure of the B plus tree is very simple structure, and the term we are using, the internal node and leaf node, we are using simple way. To avoid the unnecessary confusion, it is better idea to, I have just explained this example to other students as well. So I'm sharing this example to you once again over here. Everything is clear and Crystal is mentioning over here. So let us understand an example of the B plus tree. So as I'm speaking once again over here, B plus tree, the objective of the B plus tree to search an element in the tree. So that is the point we have to focus properly. Suppose we have to search the 55 into the given example over here. So if you try to search an element, so you can say we will to see what are the intermediate nodes we have, and as per the rules of the our, as per the rules of the our B plus tree, so 55 is a key value, and 55 is a key value. So 55 is greater than 25 from the intermediate node. You can see, just I'm highlighting the my terms. Yes, now sir. So 55 is our key value. If this 55 is a key value, then definitely 55 is greater than 25. So definitely, what we have to do? We have to take the steps to right side. So now we will not take 25. Okay. Now again, we have to move to over here. Again, 55 is bigger than the 50. It means we have to move to the right side. So we will not talk about the 50 parts right now. So on the left side, right, on the right side, what is the yes on the right side, what is the internal node we have? So we have this internal node. So I'm filling by the green color, then you can easily see. So this is the internal node that belong to the right side. So 75 is greater than 55. It means 55 is less than 75. So left side we have to take care. So now it means the internal node we have to choose that lies between the 50 and 75 from the internal node. So now we have to move this point. And in this case, you can easily say, I'm just highlighting the concept or the nodes. In this case, you can easily say, you can easily say 50, 60, 55, 65, and 70, we have the four elements. Now we found over here that is element that belong to the this range to 75, or third iterator node that will be considered as a third leaf node. So we will use a particular leaf node. So we found our element was lying in this leaf node. It doesn't mean it is exist or not, but if it exists, then we will see it is, it would be inside the this part. So this is a case where we found the our searching the element. Okay. This concept is clear to all right now, or any doubt? So if you have, please, you can ask. Everything is written over here. So I'm explaining by the different color. So I hope it will be clear to all. But you are having doubt, so you can ask me right now. Tell me any doubt here. Just tell me any doubt.
No, sir.
Okay, suppose I need to search the 36. So what I should do? Can anyone tell me right now? Suppose I need to search the 36 key value. Now, what I should do? Can you tell me right now?
Firstly, we will check with the 25. It, is it greater than 25 or less than 25?
Okay, then, super.
Since the 30, sir, are you talking about 36, no?
Yes, sir, 36.
So 36, since we know that 36 is greater than 25, then we move to the next table, which is 25-30 and 35-40. So we will point this only.
Okay, so if you see 36.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, I have a doubt. That means all these observations are in ascending order.
Yeah, that is a good point you're observing here.
So see? We can use a binary tree search log n means half ended.
Yes, of course. See, as a binary search tree, if we're having, so as per the rule of the binary search tree, I'm speaking over here. If you have any idea about the binary search tree, as per the rule of the binary search tree, all the elements we are picking inside the internal node or diff node, that should be in shorted way. It is mandatory. So that's why we can't say over here the element cannot be ascending or descending order. It should be. It's a rule. It's mandatory. When we are using any BST, that is a binary search tree, all the elements should be from the shorted order. So here we have the ascending order. So 25, 50, 75, we are picking over here. That is in the at the form of the internal node. But in the case of the leaf node, so all the elements that lies here, 5, 10, 15, 20, are also forming the ascending order. It means sorted order. Definitely should be. So that is a good observation you are having. Yes, as per the rules of the BST. But right now,
so,
I am not
sir, means if we have to find any record, then its time complexity should be log n.
Okay. Yes, yes. Tell me.
So its time means if you want to see, find that 36 is there or not, so its time complexity should be log n.
Depend on the your problem, but by default, when talking about the time complexity, then it could be log n. Yes, of course, I agree with this point. But if you are looking at the more and more records, so it can increase by the log n. So depend on the problem, depend on the situation. By default, what is the binary search tree? We have the time complexity. So as per the binary search tree, we have the log n complexity. So we will consider time complexity same as over here. But depend on the some situation, it can increase, it can be amendment. So there will be no issue. But by default, it will followed by the n log n complexity, of course. So 36, I was talking about 36. So 36 is smaller than the 50. So we will talk about the this internal node. It means the value which is lying over here. So the internal node that is representing by over here will be considered between this one. So now 25 to 40, it means we have an element inside this one. It doesn't mean the element does not belong, but if it's having, so we can say the element was searched inside the second leaf node. So as per our example, the node was searched from the third leaf node. So we have this part. So that is simple thing. Yes, now tell me, any doubt? Yes, tell me. This example is clear?
Yes, sir.
So where is the problem actually? Where is the problem actually? The problem is coming while discussing the insertion. So you can observe over here while inserting an element inside the existing B plus tree. So if I'm trying to insert the 60, so you can observe over here as per the our concept, we try to insert the 60. So 60 is an element that lies between the 50 to 75. 50 to 75 range, we have a third leaf node. In third leaf node, we can put the 60 here. We can put the 60 over here. 60 will be put inside the in this leaf node. But what is the problem actually? You can observe over here the size. The size. If talking about the size of the leaf node, you can say if we have the leaf node that pulling the size 4. So maximum or minimum, we can say if I'm increasing, if I'm adding one more element, then what would the size? Size will be the n plus 1, that is the 4 plus 1 to 5. But that is the violating the rules. So as per the rules, here what we have to do, we have to split our leaf node into two parts. So that is the point here we have written over here. While adding one more element, we have to split our leaf node, and after splitting or during the splitting our node, that is a point we have a term fill factor. So if we are filling the our node or value 60 inside our B plus tree. So the point we can observe over here, the balance, the tree must be balanced. A tree is not balancing because we are having the size n plus 2. At most we can have n, and is smaller than the n plus 1. So again we have a problem. So that is the reason you can say we have to understand this thing in simple way. So at most you can have the n, or at least you can have the n by 2. So from this point, as per the rules of our B plus tree, we have to understand the concept while inserting the element. So what we have done, it is written over here in the third leaf node has the value 50, 55, 60, and 65, because 60 is added or inserted here. So its current root node is 50, its current node node will be 50. So that is the point you can see, observe over. I'm just highlighting this point. The third leaf node has the value 50, 60, 55, 65, 70, and is its current root node is 50. So how it has become 50? Because I'm splitting my two parts. One is the 50, 55, and 60, 65, and 70. So from this point, you can observe over here, we have to pick an element that define the what is the root node we can have. So 50, 55, just 50 to 55, these I can take. So 4 divided by 2, I can take. So this can be the minimum. So that belong to the 50. That belong to the 50 root node. So it is just making the good point. So we can say it is forming the root 50. But when talking about this case, when I'm highlighting this, when talking about this 50 or 65 or 20, where we have added the 60. So what would be the root node? So again, we have an issue actually. How we can say what would be the root node? This one. How we can say this can become a 50. So that is the point we are dealing with over here. So from this point, you can take the maximum, you can take the n, so that is 4, and minimum you can take the 2. So here you are putting the 3, so it will also possible. So 3 element can be possible, but in this case 60 will be the root node of this one, or that will be the part of the intermediate node over here. So here we are putting this over this symbol over here. So we will split the leaf node of the tree in the middle so that its balance is not altered. If you're not splitting, so balance will be balance is disturbed, or we are not having the good balance because 5 cannot be acceptable, or you can accept maximum. So we can make the group 50, 55, and next group we have the 60, 65, and 75 in two leaf nodes. And that is a simple thing. But it is not easy job. We can doing this thing in simple way, but here what we are observing over here, you are increasing the unnecessarily memory. If you try to add, then you are doing anything, but no problem. But we are having an extra leaf node. Previously we had a 4 leaf node, but now we have the 5 leaf node. So for what we are doing, observe over here, after inserting 60, we are observing that we have n plus 1 leaf node, and it's showing the overflow, because as per our given example, we have the 4 only. So we are adding the one more leaf node. So what we are having, we are following the overflow, and that is a problem. So in the normal scenario, it is very easy to find the node, but it fits and place it in the leaf node. But in some other cases, when we have the huge amount of the data at a time, how we can resolve such issues? That was my problem. That was my point I'm discussing over here, overflow. So overflow will occur. And this can be reversed. This can be reversed while deleting. So after deleting the 60 and 50, I'm removing, suppose that. So at a time, I will be informed the underflow. So underflow can also be happen because I can have only the minimum 2, but I'm having right now the one. How I can adjust this one element into the 3 different elements? That is a case where I can have the underflow. So maximum and minimum I need to take care properly. So while adding the one node, it may cause an problem. It may cause an issues, that is overflow issues. That is a point we have to keep in mind while learning the B plus tree. Okay. So unlike addition, we can also have the deletion. So deletion is saying to us, you can also delete something. Delete something means delete the element. So 50 was removed. So after removing 60, we are getting the original B plus tree example as we have seen the premier set. So but the point we have to keep in mind while removing or adding anything, the tree will not satisfying the rule. So we can say the tree if not satisfying the rule. So we can say therefore in the some problems. But if tree is not satisfying the rules, so what is the problem? Because we are not following the rules of the B plus tree property. If you are following the rules of the B plus tree property, so we are following the concept properly. This is simple things we have to keep in mind. So I have already written two important points over here. One is the rule must be followed by the B plus tree, of course, and B plus tree must be balanced. And here we are balancing the each and everything. But while balancing the B plus tree, after adding the one more element, you are having the one problem. What is that? You are having the extra leaf node, and that causes a overflow inside the memory, and that is a big problem. So while inserting or removing node and element, we have to take care of the, all those things. Okay. So right now, you have any doubt? So you can ask me. Else, we can move to the next topic, that is hashing. Yes, tell me right now any problem. Yes, tell me, any student, any problem in the B plus tree? Any problem? Yes, tell me any problem so far, or should I move to the continue? Can I move to the continue part?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Hashing. And this is most important part here, but very interesting part is simple concept we have over here. Hashing. Hashing is saying to us when we have the huge data structure. I'm speaking something, I'm highlighting some important point, and those highlighted point you have to keep in mind while learning the hashing. Hashing is basically itself is a data structure, and that is represented for the searching purpose. Just like the stack view, linked list, tree, graph, hashing itself is a data structure, and it is basically used to search the element. So in a huge amount of data structure, the point you have to keep in mind, database structure, it is very inefficient to search all the index value and reach to the desired data. So hashing technique is used to calculate the direct location of the data record on the disk without using the index structure. So without changing or without seeing the index structure, we can easily look at the particular information or particular such the element that is to be done by the one important point concept that is known as the hash function. In this technique, this is the point you people are required to highlight. So I'm just marking this concept in a block. This is the important point you have to keep in mind. In this technique, data is stored at the data block whose address is generated by using the hashing function. Now here we have a question, what is the hashing function? I will tell you, don't worry. So the memory location where these records are, the memory location where these records are stored is known as the data bucket or data block. So please keep in mind my words, what I'm speaking over here. So data bucket and data blocks we have over here, and hashing we have. So hashing is what actually? Hashing basically is a concept. It requires a function to manipulate your data properly. So that is known as the hashing function. And in the hashing function, some memory location where these records, these information are to be stored properly, and where the information to be stored, that is to be known as the data bucket or data blocks. These are the various terms you people are required to understand properly. After understanding this point, what is the next point we can observe over here? We have the hash function. So hash function, you can choose the hash function by choosing the any key column value or any key elements. So what is the key element or key value we can choose? We can choose the hash function by applying the hash function on the key element, and that key element will be identified by as a attribute or column name. So a hash function can choose any one of the value to generate the address. That is a simple thing we have to keep in mind. All these things which is highlighting me over here, people see through an example. So this picture will be clear to all in simple way. And most of the time, the hash function uses the primary key. That is a point again. So most of the time, the hash function uses the primary key. I'm highlighting the primary key over here to generate the address of the data block. A hash function is simple mathematical function to any complex mathematical function, and we can consider the primary key itself as an address of the data block. So that means each row whose address will be the same as the primary key stored into the data block. To avoid the just unnecessary part, I have this example over here. This example will clear the picture in simple. Now it is visible to all right now. This picture or this image is visible to all right now. Just let me know right now. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
So in this picture, what I have just explaining, just focus on the my words properly. Just listen. We have a data report. So 98.103.106.105.107.104.102 and so on. Same in the data bucket address, we have the 98.102.103.104.105.106.120. Okay, just understand this is not 100. So please keep in mind this is not 100. This is 98. Okay, so understand this is 98. So 98.103.104 respectively we have. So the point you have to keep in mind here in the data bucket address, in the data bucket address, we have the same value as a primary key we are assuming we are having. So what is the primary key? The primary key of the employee ID. So if this is a record 98 John Delhi and 103 John US, 104 Kartikan UP, 105 Honey China, and 106 Jackson Delhi. All these are the records actually. And in this case, we have the employee ID, employee name, and employee location. So from this point, what we are picking? We are picking the employee ID as a key attribute. Okay, so we are making this one as our data bucket address. So 98 we are making, 102 we are making, and respectively we are making the 103, 104, and 105, and 106. And this step will go on till 120. From this, we have to take the data record. So data record address we are picking as a primary key value. So we are picking. So from this point, the data record could be any memory location different. So 98 is what actually, these are the primary key, but in the record, we are assuming here, this would be as a memory location of the particular record. So 103 John US, that is a record. So 103 is a employee ID, and that becomes as a memory location only. So we are assuming the same property. But here we have the huge volume of the information 98, 102, 103, 104. In this case, how to troubleshoot such problem? This problem can be resolved within the simple way. You can create your own function, and this function we can define by the linear programming concept. And the hashing, we have a simple concept, that's why we can create. So what I did over here, I create a function that is HK, K mode 5. Why I'm creating the mode 5? Because as per this theory, we have, suppose we have mode 5 hash function to determine the address of the data block. So what are the data blocks? The 98, 102, 105, 103, 104, 106, all these are the data blocks. Okay, so all these data blocks we can transform into the our calculated hash values. So how we can create? So HK is equal to K mode 5. And it is also written over here. You can use any one of the function, whatever you want to pick, it's your choice. You want to create any function that you can create. You can choose the exponential, you can choose a mode, you can use a cos, and you can use a sine, etc. But as per the my theory or as per the my just study, I have been observed 99.9% people will like to use mode operator to calculate the hash function. So that's why I have written over here HK equal to K mode 5. So why I'm 5? Because I'm just, as per the my theory point, it is given that you have to take the mode 5 to determine the address of the data block. Now, in this key, K is a key. This is a key value I need to put. So what is a key value? This is a key value I need to take from the data bucket address part. So this address I need to put over here, and I need to transform this information into the form of the hash function. So let me explain one thing right now, then you can easily see. Just let me explain one. If I'm trying to implement the 103, suppose that 103, 104, whatever you want to implement, you can use implement anyone. Suppose I'm implementing 103. So I'm just writing over here. H103 key value, that is as a primary key I'm taking an employee ID 103. Now what is the value? It is 103 mode 5. You know this is the value of the our functions from our function. We are choosing the key value and n, that is 5 is given. So 103 mode 5, if I'm doing so, I will get the 3 undoubtedly. So H 103, we will get the 3. So that's why I have written over the 3. 102 is 3, 2, 98 will be 3. Okay, so just do not interpret 100, this is the 98. And 105, I will get the 0. Of course, undoubtedly 106 will be the 1 and 102 will be 102, 120 will be the 0. And that is the point. So instead of the writing the all these things, we can use a hash function to simplify the all the things, and we can write the concept in simple way. Now see, like this. The data bucket address can be replaced by the calculated hash function. Please underline this point right now. I'm underlining once again to all the people. Data buckets address can be replaced by calculated hash function. So now it is replaced by this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 106 we have maximum. So we got the 6, we can get the 1. So depending on the situation, what the value we are getting. Now, from this point, you can easily say, I'm writing the all this value in shorted way. You can put the 0, of course, undoubtedly. So what is the value 1 we are getting? So we are putting the its record, that is the 106 James Delhi. 2 we have the 102, how USB coming? 98 Alia UK is coming over here. 4 Jackson China is coming over here. Okay, this is only rough data. But 3 is case 98 while solving the 98 mode 3. So I'm getting 98 mode 3, I'm getting 3. 103 mode 5, 3 I'm doing, so I'm getting the 3 again. So this is the record which will be written like this one over here. Why? Because this is the part of the same kind of the data bucket address in form of the calculated hash functions. So that would be the part of the same different kind of the address we can use. So things are not easy. Okay, it has also drawback. Why? Because in the after reading the 98, it will keep the record of the, or it will keep the pointer of the 103 record as well, because there is chain, because they, both these record belong to the same hash function value. That is the reason we can say over here, that is a simple reason we can say we are following this pattern. But it is not easy thing. So far we have seen what is the mean by the hash function and how to determine the, how to determine the function, how to determine the calculated thing. This is just idea about the hashing right now. Okay, if you have any doubt so far, you can ask me right now. Else, I can start the typing of various type of the static hash function and dynamic hash function. Then we will see what is the drawback, what is the advantage, the disadvantage. One. Just tell me right now, any problem so far you have, so you can ask me right now. Just tell me, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so when talking about the type of the hashing, so we have the two types of the hashing flavor. One is static hashing and dynamic hashing. Now, let me start from the static hashing. Everything is written on the my PPT, and it will help you to understand the concept after taking this class in concise way. In hashing function, static hashing, the resultant data bucket address will always be the same. That means we generate an address employee ID 103. By using the hash function mode 5, then it will always result the same bucket 3. This is the point. Employee ID 103 we are having, that belong to the 3, and same which is also having by the 98 as well. But once it is defined, it cannot be changed. What is the problem over here? Now see, 98 also having the same records of we are defining. 103 also defining same thing, so it is making a chain. Okay, just please focus on the my word. It is making a chain. So that is to be done by the static function. The static function, once we have calculated the hash function, that will be the resultant value, that is the 3, it will be 3. It cannot be changed. That is the point. So here what we are having, the static. It means once we have calculated, it would be the part as it is. There will be no change in the our bucket address. We have to assign the 103 into the 3. Previously it was assigned to the 98. That is reason. So hence in the static hashing, the number of the data bucket in memory remains constant throughout. In this example, we have 5 data buckets in the memory used to store the data. Let us understand this point right now. I was explaining another example. Yeah. So now this, yeah, no problem. So in this case, 104 Jackson, China is below. So if I'm adding the 109, if I'm trying to determine the hash key value of the hashing function value of the 109 BSK India, suppose this record I'm trying to insert or I'm trying to calculate the hash function. So HK K modern, so 109 mode 5 I'm doing, so I'm getting the 4. So what I have to do, I have to make a chain just like this one, 109 BSK. And next we have the India. Okay, so VSK is my short name, so I'm writing in short way. So this record will make as a chain. That is not a part of this one. We can't take over here in the 6 and 5, I can't take. So that is a problem I'm having. So in the static means I have decided, I have just calculated that will be the part only that one. So we can't change the data bucket address. So what are the various operation we can perform? So searching a record, inserting a record, delete a record, update a record can be done. Unlike performing any operation on the record, we can perform any one of the operation, whatever you want to do, just searching, inserting, deleting, updating. So all these operations we have easily implemented on without any doubt. So open hashing. Open hashing is one kind of the static hashing, and it is saying to us how you can understand the problem. You can understand this problem. In the static hashing, we have two types of one more flavor. One is open hashing, another one is closed hashing. What is the sense of this one? Let us understand. When a hashing function generates an address at which data is already stored, and the next bucket will be allocated to this mechanism will be the linear probing. So see, this is the point. Now I'm coming back to my example. In this case, you are observing over here. You are observing over here. 98 is already allowed. 98 earlier, you can, this is record is already assigned to 3. This record is already assigned to 3. And 103 ME, we are doing, I'm also assigning to 3. But we found that we can assign only the one data bucket address to the one record only. So at a time, what we have to do? We have to assign 103 MB UK address to the 4 data bucket. But on the 4 data bucket, it is founding that again we have another record. So now what we should do? We will see, this will be assigned the here. We will assign this one here in case of the where we can assign. Can anyone tell me right now? In the see, next bucket will be allocated to the 8, to the mechanism known as the linear probing, and the example is known as the open hashing. So that is the point. This example, which is known as the open hashing. Open hashing. See, if any data bucket is empty, so we can assign. Suppose on the 5 data bucket of any record belongs to, so we can move to 6. Else we can see. If all the data buckets are filled, so we can say we are doing the overflow. Okay, that is the point. And that is a big issue again. But right now we have the empty data bucket, so we can assign over here. In the reverse part of the open hashing, but the point we have to keep in mind, this is the concept you can understand by the linear probing. This linear probing is the name of the method inside the hashing, and that we have to study inside the data structure subject as well. So here, this example I have already given in the concise bit. Okay. So now I'm focusing on the close hashing right now. Close hashing is saying to us when buckets are full. That was my point. I was coming on that point. So bucket are full and then new data bucket is allocated for the same hash function. Result in the linked after the previous one. This mechanism known as the overflow. So now what we are doing right now. Now I'm coming on the my point right now. Yes. Suppose all the buckets are full. This is also full. This is also full. Suppose that. So now if what we have to do, we don't have any open chance to fill the any buckets. Now we are close. Our finger are fixed to close the apply the this data bucket as a closeness manner. So what we have to do? We have to by using the linked links manner, we have to apply same data bucket to the existing data bucket that is the tree, but we have to make a link between the previous record and the existing record. So here we are calling the close. Let me try to cut. Following the close hashing. But when all are full, when we are seeing where all are not filled, then we will use the open hashing. So after applying the open hashing, now all the data buckets are full. So now we have to apply the close hashing by making a link this or by making the communication. And this is known as the overflow chaining. So this example is a part of the overflow chaining inside the chaining in the hashing concept in the data structure. Those who have studied, they know the concept. This is a simple concept. Now it is also marked over here. One second. Okay, now clear? Just tell me, any doubt over here?
No, sir.
Okay, so now after this point, what do I have to do? We can see the dynamic hashing. This dynamic hashing is saying to us what is the problem we are having with the static hashing, that is the bucket overflow. Now you can observe over here, bucket overflow is going on. Now what is the bucket overflow? In this case, you have to see we are not increasing the bucket size. Data bucket address, we are not increasing. Whatever address we are using, that will be fixed. So 126 we have, 126 we can have. We can't allow to update, we can't allow to edit or do anything over here. We can use only the hits as it is part right now. Okay. So after this point, what we have to do? We have to understand the concept properly. In the static hashing, we are observing we have the so many drawbacks and we have the some over we have the some problems. But what is the exit problem? In the bucket, you can see observe over here, we have the limited number of the buckets. Either we can follow the close hashing or open hashing. But is there any chance we can increase the bucket size? And that can be done inside the dynamic hashing. So let us understand dynamic hashing, what is saying to us. Dynamic hashing method used to overcome the problems of the static hashing like bucket overflow. And in this method, data buckets grows or shrink as the record increases or decreases. This method is also known as the extendable hashing method. And this method makes hashing dynamic and it allows insertion deletion without resulting the poor performance. While if we try to insert some data, the underflow overflow case will be there. So this has been done inside this part. So how to search the key? Yes. So there are simple concept, nothing else, especially calculate the hash address of the key. So we have seen this concept with the help of the hash k equal to k mod n. That is a n means any integer value, and check how many bits are used in the directory. So these bits are all called as i's, I means as integer only. And take the least significant i bits of the hash address. This gives an index of the directory. But in the case of the dynamic hashing, we will prefer to use as i as a binary. So now using the index, go to the directory and fix bucket, find bucket address where the record might be. So this find bucket address means we are talking about the, we are using the bucket address value, which are replaced by the calculated hash function. And the find bucket address we have already seen inside the hash static casing. But in the case of dynamic hashing, we have to determine the binary concept. So let us understand this concept with the help of an example. Before that, how to insert the native code? So the theory portion is written over here. Firstly, you have to follow the same procedure for the table ending of the system bucket, as we have seen the static hashing. If there is still space, some space in the bucket, then place and record it. There will be no issue. But bucket is full, then we will split the bucket and redistribute the record. It means this step is saying to us, we are trying to increase or decreasing the size of the bucket as per our demand, as per our problem, and that is redistribution of the record will be there. Let us understand this concept with the help of one example. Here we have one example. I'm showing over here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have these are the 6, 7 keys, and respectively hash address we have. So now we have to assign this hash address in a bucket address data bucket. So how we can assign? So you can observe over here, I'm picking the last two digits of each and every hash address. So you can observe over 10, 00, 01, and 11. So as per the my different colors symbols or arrow symbol, you can easily say I'm picking the four different kind of data records. One, those which belong to the 00, 10, 11. So the hash address whose last two bits belong to the 00, they will be considered as a first bucket, that is the B0 bucket. Then B1, B2, B3, so we have the four different buckets. So 01 bucket, 01 will be considered as a 5, 6. 10 will be represented by the 23 and 11 represented by the 7. As you can see the arrow. But now if I need to try to insert the 9 in with the hash address 1001. So at the time you can observe over here, if I try to insert new element, then how to manage the such thing? So that is the point we can observe over here. If I'm trying to do, so when try to do 9, I can store. So 01 I can pick. 01 I can pick, and then I have to use the first bucket, then I can put. So what I can do? I'm showing my observation over here with the help of the arrow. What I can do? I can as per the 01 observation of the 9 value after transforming to the binary, I can put to
अब तो हम आराम हम
सो आई कैन पुट 9 इनसाइड द 5, 6 पार्ट बट देयर इज कंडीशन ओनली देयर इज कंडीशन इज ओनली व्हाट बट यू कैन पुट ओनली द डेटा बकेट यू कैन पुट ओनली द टू की वैल्यू इनसाइड द डेटा बकेट दैट वाज अ प्रॉब्लम सपोज वी हैव दिस प्रॉब्लम एट अ टाइम हाउ वी कैन मैनेज Suppose we have the 3, so we can insert the 3 undoubtedly. But in the case of the here, it should be the 9. Here it should be 9. But if I'm observing, if I'm putting the 9 over here, then what you are observing over here, you can put the maximum 2 values inside the data bucket of the keys. So, but you can't pick the 3, you can put the 3. So at a time, there will be problem. So to resolve such issues, what I'm doing right now, what we are doing, we are making the group of the three last digit. Okay, so the point, the splitting, you see, three last digit. So what are bits? 00, 01, 010, 011, 100, 101, and 110, and 111, and 111. So what I'm doing right now, I'm just making the 3 bits group, last 3 bits I will pick instead of the 2 bits. So same pattern I'm pulling observe over here. And now see, by applying this approach, the data bug, the value that belong to the 000, so 24 will come. So you can observe over here, 2, 4 will come. Okay, so 2, 4 is coming. So 2, 4 is coming over here. Coming over here. Same thing, 001. So 5, 9 is coming over here. So of course 5, 9. So 001, 9 is also having the 9 also having the 001. So 9 is also coming here. So 5, 9 will come over here. And this step will go on. So now we have the this one. See, this is a simple example of the dynamic hashing. This is a simple example of the dynamic hashing. Okay. And bucket size, we have the 2. Bucket size is given 2. So at a time, we can't put the 3. That is the point. So this is a simple example of the dynamic hashing. So what is the advantages part of the dynamic hashing? In this method, in a dynamic hashing, the performance does not decrease, the data grows the system. It simply increases the memory to accommodate the data. So when the data size increasing, so it increases the data bucket size as well. In this method, memory is well utilized, it is grow and sync with the data. So dynamically, it is just adjusting the memory data size according to the bucket size, of course. And there will not be unused any memory line. That is a good pattern. And this method is good for the dynamic database where data grows or sync frequently. And this is that good way. But what are the drawbacks? We have to keep in mind the thing properly. In this method, if the data size increase, then bucket size also increase. That is a big problem. Because it means bucket size is depend on the data size. That is the point. Here bucket size means I'm not talking about the bucket sizes. Here bucket size we have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bucket size means I was talking about the, just let me write correctly. Bucket size means I'm talking about the key values. Okay, key value size. In buckets, so size is 2. That is right. Okay, the bucket size here we have the 5 actually, but key value size here in the bucket we have the 2. Okay, so when the data size increases, the bucket size will also be increased. That is a point we have to keep in mind. So this is a problem. So this is not easy to maintain by the address. So these addresses of the data will be maintained in the bucket, I'll say, address table. And this is because of the data address will keep changing, the buckets grows and sync. If there's a huge increase of data, so maintaining the bucket size will also become the tedious. So that is the point. So this is again same sense we have over here. While increasing the data size, we have to increase the bucket size as well. So again, we have to maintain. And in this case, a bucket overflow situation will also occur. It might take little time to reach the situation than static hashing. So it is not easy to maintain because everything depends on the overflow. So overflow is occurring, so it is not easy to maintain. That was a problem. Okay. So this point you have to keep in mind properly. Okay, students. Right now, tell me any doubts so far you have. So please, you can ask me.